Welcome back to Making History in Kerbal Space Program 1.4. And of course, we got a few things to do. First of all, I did upgrade the mission control. We're now at level 2, which means we got flight planning, which means I can actually stop flying blind and actually start planning things a little bit ahead of when we actually go through things. So let's take a look at the missions. And I did a couple to gain this amount of money. I think we were around 160 last episode or something like that. I put in a couple of missions, upgraded and a couple more missions. Nothing special, nothing, you know, outstanding. None of these sort of signature missions. So we do still need to do that. So I don't think I have the docking port yet, though. So I guess what I would have to have the docking port for that. So why don't we look at something like this? So take a crew report in space flight. That's going to need a manned mission. Okay, I guess we can do that, maybe. Yeah, why don't we take a look at that one? So it's in spaceflight above these, so that means it should be fairly easy to go over them at any particular point. Of course, the further away from the moon in this case we are, the longer our period of rotation, which means that we could easily miss these the further we go, because in the time it takes for us to go around the moon once, that might actually go past us. And normally we put a satellite, or in this case a manned mission, in a polar orbit so that the moon can rotate underneath us. So we may have to be we may have to wait a little while. Because it's a vanilla playthrough, we don't have life support as such. We only really need solar power, or electricity, essentially. So let's take that, and let's see if we can get that sorted. So, back into our ship. This is the Unmunar Express. This is the one I did for the missions that I did off-camera. Nothing too special, but I may as well go through it anyway, because we may be using it later in this episode. I'm not quite so sure yet. So we've got a service bay in here, and inside there is our Octo version 1. So, and it has a couple of batteries on either side of it. In fact, they're not centered. I think I'm just going to center those. There we go. Oh, there we go. Yeah, that makes me feel a whole lot better. So we've got two mystery goo containment units, and we've got a thermometer and a barometer, and that's our payload bay, or service bay, if you like. And that does actually attach. Can I just close it? Yep. Got a nose cone, just to provide something on the way up, because we don't really have any sort of payload bays yet, so I can't just hide this in a payload bay, otherwise I would. And a few solar panels, not too many, but 6 solar panels? Yeah. And a deployable antenna, and one of these Communitron 16Ss. Otherwise, it's pretty much the same kind of rocket we've been using before. You'll see the Delta V is 6,700, or thereabouts total. So the first stage on this thing doesn't really get us into orbit. And in fact, if you have a look at the thrust weight ratio, it's really low. So it takes quite a while to take off. But once this next stage takes over, it'll get us all the way into orbit and then all the way to the moon. But because this is a crew report, well, let's save that. As the Munar Express. Oh, that's this load screen, sorry. We want the Munar Express, I think. Load. Yes. So we don't necessarily need anything like, for example, this. And we probably have all that science anyway. We could put a science bay on this thing, but our Delta V is 5,344. So that should be just fine. And indeed, we don't even need the science experiment storage unit. So we can get rid of that, make it cheaper. This just needs a crew report, so we can take anything else off that we want or don't want. There we go, down to 12,485, and that will do just fine. Who's going to be going out there? Oops, wrong button. Crew. Jebediah? We could probably switch again with Valentina. That will do just fine. Maybe I should put some of those science experiments back. And anyway, you've seen me do this before, so I'm going to just make sure the staging is correct. Yeah, all looks fine. Save that and head over there. No need for you to see the orbital ascent. Okay, so here we are in orbit. Now we have the ability. Let me just actually move this a little bit. We've got enough electric charge, I think. But let me just rotate us a little bit this way. Just to make sure some of that light shines on here. So sun exposure. Yeah, that'll do. Just to make sure. Our SAS should bring us to a halt. And we can start looking at what we can do here. So this is one of my previous satellites. One of the previous missions. I don't necessarily need it anymore, but it is up there. And then if we go out to here and focus on this, you'll see I have this other satellite as well. There it is. That was my Unmunar Express that I was showing you in the VAB. It's out here. It was initially below 10,000 meters. So it was skimming the surface, but I've brought it out here so that we it really doesn't have much of an issue getting blocked by the sun, of course, if we ever need it. And this is our mission sort of coordinates we need to fly over. So again, we probably want to put ourselves into a polar orbit to do that. Now, polar orbits aren't all that complicated to get to. They're normally easiest to actually do when you're halfway out there. You can adjust things with a very small amount of delta V. So if we just have a look back around about here, we know we probably want to start around about here and add a maneuver. And I don't have any mods like MechJeb here, so I'm going to do this the old-fashioned way. Not that there's anything wrong with that, you understand, but there we go. So we've got a periapsis, and if we just go and focus to the moon, you'll see how close we are. So here we are, 336 kilometers. And if I click over here, hopefully it'll give me the controls, so I can use the mouse scroll wheel to scroll in both directions. And it will probably help if I actually come on a collision course. And then we control this with a little bit of normal. Can't really do much at this stage. So let's just leave it out here just to make sure we're not going to have any problems. And then when we're about halfway out, we're going to have another maneuver. So let's actually do this first maneuver first, shall we? And it's 24 minutes until we need to actually move to that. So we can use backspace and warp to around about here. And we'll go around the planet. Quite pretty. We're going to start losing some light, but that's okay. Our electric charge is doing just fine. And in up comes the sunrise. Very pretty with scatterer, providing all the clouds and the atmospheric stuff for EVA as well. That will all do very nicely. And as we come up to this, we're going to time warp out and point at the node. Now, of course, Valentina doesn't have enough experience yet to actually just for me just click node, and we don't have smart ASS from MechJeb, so I do have to actually fly all of this manually just to show you that I actually can fly these things, as opposed to the realism overhaul series where you really have to use MechJeb. There's no two ways about it. So here we come. So node in 1 minute 4 seconds. This is estimated to burn 23 seconds for this stage, this engine. That's not quite good, because the next stage is going to be this engine. So I think I'm going to leave early and we'll correct in flight. So burn of 23 seconds. Normally I'd wait until 10 seconds in, but I think I'm going to go around about, well, we should be seeing the moon soon. I think I'm going to go around about 30 seconds and we'll see how well that does. We should have more control over this than last time. So here it comes, 32, 30 gone. And here's where we see how far off we are. So there goes that stage. That can get dropped. And in comes this stage. Okay, so that's an estimated burn of another 30 seconds, which is all right. You know, we can do it just fine. And let's just go and see what this does to our orbit as we head to the moon. So out it comes. We should have enough fuel. Let's just make sure we're centered on that node. It's come all the way out here, so let's start decreasing our throttle all the way down. And in comes our track. There we go. So let's leave it there for the moment. We're happy with that. Start another maneuver up. And now we can adjust things to a much finer degree than before. Yeah, everything's fine there. So add a maneuver, And now we can control this using these. So if I want to move this, it's not anywhere near as hard to actually do that. And we're going to just adjust this so that we end up in a polar orbit, or roughly polar, I think. 66, that'll be 2 second burn, so that shouldn't be much of an issue for this. I'm not going to be too concerned about being exactly polar. I want to be fairly close, however, just because when I circularize, that's of benefit, and we don't want to miss any of these when we do crew reports. So that will do just fine. I can then turn. It's a lot easier to turn now that we don't have that big bottom stage with vanilla KSP's magical reaction wheels. Even those causes some issues. And we are pointing solar panels towards the sun like that. So we don't have any issues with electric charge. Fine. So we can then just backspace, get back to there. Zoom out and then warp to here. Now we don't have to be exact by getting on this node, because halfway out like this, it is so lenient in terms of where you apply this that it really shouldn't matter. So let's go back over to the moon and let's start moving our orbit. See, with very small amounts of thrust, we should be able to adjust this on our maneuver node just fine. It's going to start rotating through the moon. There it goes. And then it's going to transform up above the moon towards our maneuver node. Well, a maneuver track, or whatever you want to call it. And that will do just fine. So there we can then set up another maneuver here to burn retrograde. And it doesn't really matter so much what the other side of this is. Sort of circular would be fine. That's a burn of 8 seconds, so quite a long burn. We can leave it further out and save on that. Of course, the problem with them will be that it will take quite a long time to go around. But because these are these above? Above. Hopefully that'll be okay. If not, we can always refine it. So to do that burn, we're going to then move out to here and warp. Hopefully this is, yeah, it's still facing the sun. There's no problem. Here up comes the moon. Just fine. And we should be coming in over there. Yes, we are. And coming in this way. We don't have much of a signal strength. That's okay. It's not like we're transmitting stuff and we are manned, so we don't have to worry about losing connection and control. So let's warp all the way in. And again, really doesn't matter too much with this particular orbit whereabouts we go here. So this is just going to be burning retrograde pretty much. And 6 seconds, but that's only if we go full throttle. There we go. So we can stop anytime we actually wanted to here. We've got, not circularization, but we've got a closed orbit now. The only thing we've got to watch is we have to get back to Kerbin. And that's something we need to take care of. So I'm going to then finish here. And then all I really need to do now, as long as I'm facing the sun and we don't have any issues with electric charge, when I, let's just actually make sure I am facing the sun. So let's just figure out which direction that is. That's fine right there. We don't have to start spinning or anything. Valentina is really happy about this. And we're fine to disengage SAS, which I don't think actually uses any electric charge. So we're okay now. And of course, as with most of these missions, we're just going to revolve around. And I think that it's going to be rotating sort of from left to right. So if I just increase this, you'll see the whole planet, moon, is rotating. And our orbital track is the same. Okay. And of course, as we go around Kerbin, there's going to become a point where we're going to end up behind the moon. Right now, we're not. We're always in sunlight. So that's really good when you've got life support systems and other stuff like that. Not that we have to worry about it just yet. And I can't walk faster than a certain amount below a certain altitude. So that is okay too. And in it comes. Will we miss this? I don't think we will. I think we'll be okay for the first one. So let's bring the time warp in. And over the top. Let's take a look at this. We should be able to see them. Whoops, there's the sector. So we need to take a crew report. And transmit. Well, we're taking a crew report. That should count. Yeah, it does. Okay, so can we review this and transmit at some point? No usable in-range comm devices. Okay, well, we can override it and then just that will still count this. We don't think we have to transmit it anywhere in this particular case. So back to here, and I'm going to go and do the other two. Not going to show those on camera. No real need. We can just get through this mission. And with our final zone, we've got all three of them now. Mission time, 35 days. Valentine's a little homesick, so why don't we get her back? Let's see what it takes to get back, shall we? So we're going around the moon, sort of in that sort of clockwise on this. So what we probably want to do, well, it's not particularly efficient because I'm in a polar orbit. Let's just see how much delta V we're going to need to alter this. So that's going to alter this side. We can go normal. That's not going to really help us too much because we're going to have to change our orbit so much. Yeah, I'm going to see. Maybe I should do an inclination change first. Let me quickly take a look. Yeah, I'm just going to do this in two maneuvers. We're just going to escape the moon, first of all. That'll let me get back into a Kerbin central orbit. And then from there, you know, we'll see what we need to do. So all we need to do for this is just burn, I guess, when we're on the outside of our orbit. So we can extend this side that goes towards Kerbin itself. And we can warp to that point. So around here will do. We don't have to be terribly accurate again. It is just fine where it is. There we go. So let's just extend this outwards. Hopefully I have enough fuel. Yeah, we've got quite a bit of fuel. There we go. So we're going to escape just fine. Let's head out there. All the way to the end. I think let's just extend outwards. And there we go. So now we've got to decide how we're going to get in again. And the closest side is this side. So if we have a maneuver all the way out here, then that should be efficient, I think. And bring things in. Okay, so burn of 4 seconds. And that will take us to a periapsis of quite a lot. Yeah, let's bring our orbit in a little bit more. And a little bit more, 96. What does it take till it gets all the way down to 29? That should do it. And let's put our, this is a 7 second burn. Hopefully we've got enough delta V left to actually do this. Otherwise we could be stranded and need a lift. That'd be a whole different kind of mission. Let's see where that maneuver node is pointing us as far as the sun's concerned. It is just fine. There we go. And now we can warp all the way around. Got electric charge, no real problems. And I want to be looking not at the moon. I want to be looking at my ship. There we go. All right, so 7 seconds. Yeah, we should have more than enough for this. And we can just get a little bit more precise as we come in. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. So what are we at the moment? Periapsis is 23. Let's actually just flip over to prograde and extend that outwards a little bit more. Yeah, flip over to retrograde. Bring that in a little bit more. Wow. There, yeah, 27. That should be fine. Okay. And now we can just turn off SAS. Hopefully we are still just fine. We are. And we don't need to do anything else until we get much closer to Kerbin. So let's warp to there. Now that we have the flight planning. Oh, it's so much easier than flying blind. In we come. Okay, and time warp complete. And at this point, we can... there we are, at 27 now. That is fine. which you probably want to face, turn SAS on, face retrograde. Those solar panels will probably burn off as we come in. Let's just turn SAS off again, and let's warp in towards the planet. There we go, that little pod. Let's just turn the U back off again. It really is very beautiful with the EVE mod and scatterer. Well worth installing those on any playthrough, including vanilla. So here we are, 177 and falling. So at this point, we really don't need this engine module any longer. So let's just get rid of it, shall we? And now we can go back to retrograde, disable SAS, and enjoy this coming back into the planet, and we can head back to the space center. And Val is safely back on the surface, and we're up to 92 science, which is really important, the other thing I wanted from that mission. Because every time you can bring a vessel back from around the moon, you get a little bit of science, and, well, we didn't get much for the crew report at all. We got zero, but we got 92 science now and 394,000 funds. So one of the things that I want to spend those funds on eventually is this, but it's quite expensive. So in the meantime, we can get more science by upgrading our astronaut complex, 150,000, but at the same time, they can now go EVA in space, suit upgrades essentially, and they can place flags, which again is really good for the science, I think. It's been a while since I put flags down, but that's fine. So mission control, we still need to do this explore the moon. Oh, that's a new one. Explore the moon. Our explore Kerbin has expired. Now we have to land on the moon, and that will give us a completion of 57,600. Yes. I almost would prefer them to offer the Minmus missions first. Minmus is further out, but it's a little easier to get to and easier to land on. However, we also get another 60,000 for science data from surface of the moon, or moon. I'm never quite sure how you sort of pronounce that. I assume it's moon, it's just a play on words. But we can do other missions. Position satellite in a polar orbit of the moon. I'm going to pronounce it moon. Yep, so reach a designated polar orbit around the moon with reasonable deviation. You need a materials bay and maintain stability. So we can always get some of that money back. Before I do that, however, I want to spend on research and development. In particular, I'm not concerned about heavy rocketry yet. We don't need that until we go into planetary, really. Although you can deploy space stations using skippers and... Oh, no, that's the AJ-10. That's the new engine that I want to try, but not just yet. Fuel systems, again, we can still get away without. I actually want payload bays, and they're in here. We get the winch, but the airstream protective shell, that's the first payload sort of fairings that we actually get, and we want those to be able to deploy satellites. Otherwise, I have to sort of make them as part of the main stack. I don't have any mods that can give me procedural fairings or anything like that, so we've got some more stack separators. That's all fine and good. Engine plates, now they are new. They're, I think, part of part of the mods where you can actually deploy multiple engines on the engine plates. If you wanted to fit two on one stage, for example, and stuff like that, rather than going up to the next size engine up and various other things like that. That's, again, the new size of protective shell. That's 1.875, I think, is a new size. The default is 1.25, and there's 2.5, I assume, on the next node up. Where's the next node up? You in here? Yeah, the 2.5 is in that node. So I think I want this one. We've got structural tubes. Okay. No, don't need those. A service module, which is another type of bay. All good. And a decoupler. That looks like it's for a hot staged engine. So you see how it's not solid at the sides? To let the exhaust gases out. Otherwise you melt whatever you've got it connected to. So let's take that node, even though I want some of the other stuff quite. Yeah, space exploration, don't need. Miniaturization, don't... that's actually the docking port junior. Senior will probably be further up. relay antenna I want for satellites as well, to be honest. But we'll see what we can get away with first. Let's build, I think, to close out the episode, let's build an unmanned satellite that's better than what we have at the moment. So here's our Unmooner Express, and it's sort of kludgy because, well, this is just how we really have to construct things. We've got a part count problem of 30 parts maximum. That's the other reason why we want to do those missions, because we have to spend 450,000 on this place. So, shall we start again? Maybe? Yeah, let's start again. We can always assemble it pretty quickly. So we want to start off with the Octo, because that gives us SAS, absolutely. We can now get the fuel tanks, the Oscar Bs, and they are always, always useful. So if you want those on, that is fine again. And the Spark will get us 4,000 Delta V, which is far more than enough for an upper stage. In fact, what we could even do is just bring that down entirely to half, save a lot of weight, and we still get 3,000, even with half the number of fuel tanks. It's just how Delta V goes. And this could be in a fairing payload bay, whatever you actually want to call it. We should have inland reaction wheels just fine. Structural. I don't need any more fuel tanks, although we could buy the monoprop, I guess, at some point. I'm going to need electrical, so we're going to want solar panels on this thing. And in general, I'm going to splurge out on those. 4 solar panels will be just fine, I hope. And for an antenna, well, I guess we're going to start with something like this. Really, what we want is a relay at some point. I don't think this is... Oh, hang on, that is actually a relay. Okay. So, relay just means that it can essentially transmit by one satellite to another satellite. So it can act as an intermediary between satellites, or between vessels back to Kerbin. So if you have that as one there, and then on the other side, maybe we just put one of our small communitrons, like here or something like that. That's fairly compact, and it isn't terrible. Its Delta V has dropped to 2300 now, but that's fine. We do also want to put some batteries on, maybe, to allow for it to go behind planets. So we should probably buy this rechargeable battery bank. And then, where's the central mass on this thing? We can't really, we don't have any RCS, so it's not going to be terrible no matter where we put this thing. But might be nice to stack it up. This is down to 2278, 2236, still fine. How much charge do these have? 200 versus 100. Okay, that looks reasonable. Although I almost want to put this maybe up here somewhere, but then, that's more compact. Let me just turn the center of mass off again. That just fits without any clipping, which is what we want. And then that should probably go, well, let's just leave it there. Yeah, it's slightly off center, but that's not a problem. Okay, so we've got ourselves the basis of a satellite. Let's take a look. We don't need any heat shields. We don't need any wheels or aerodynamics, because this is going inside a payload bay. So we do have to think about a payload bay itself. And what size are these? Let's actually just buy the payload bays. Where are you? Payload 1.25. Yeah, so this is the size we want. And then we can pop this in and build this as you normally would, which is very straightforward. And we can then show we want a clamshell deploy. You almost always want ejection force up a little bit. Otherwise, they get stuck. It's not great. What color schemes can we get? Ooh, so we got gray and orange. Black and white, and then just white. I think we'll leave that with just white. Okay, so then what are we going to do below this? Depends really where we want to put the satellite. It's around 2,000 Delta V now, so we could have a satellite that would, you know, just be put into orbit by one of our, you know, swivel engines. And we can put, some fuel tanks in. I still don't have the larger fuel tanks. I still need to get these ones. That's the other thing that's contributing towards the part count as well, which we've got to be careful of. It's at 16 at the moment. So if I have 5 of those, just what is the delta V like? And make sure I need some kind of separator. A stack separator of some kind. I assume this doesn't have one built in, do you? Do you have one built in? Do you have both separator and that? Let's just assume you don't have a separator. And so stack separator is expensive in both cases. But yeah, let's go for those. We need to buy them anyway. Okay, there we go. That just makes sure that we don't have any problems with separating this. I can never remember if these actually have them built in. In procedural parts, you'd sort of need a separate separator with or sort of modded playthrough, but we'll do it in any case. So now it's showing up. So the default is 1.59, which is perfectly fine. And 4,000 delta V, which is enough to get us into orbit. So if we want something to get us just to orbit and then have the satellite do the rest of the maneuvering, this will be fine. We are going to need, however, some aerodynamics on the bottom of this thing. And in fact, should we probably upgrade to these winglets now? Yeah, or maybe. I'll just use these for now. Have 4 of them, as you might expect. How many parts are we up to? 25 out of 30. Yeah, it's a sort of very tiny Kerbalish rocket. And if we want to get further, all we really need to do is sort of take this out and then put an extra stage in here. This first stage won't be too good, but if we then do something like this and an LV909, what are you like? So you're next 2,500. So if we then put another separator and then this, whoops, this is going to be remarkably heavy and hard to steer. We're still okay in part count. We've got 2 left. And we've got to separate things here. So let's move that up. Separate fire. So we can put those in the same stage. So we would only have 2,800. That would get us into the atmosphere, but it would take off extremely slowly at 1.3. Still fine. And then this sort of orbital insertion stage would get us to orbit and maybe a bit below, beyond that if we want to. The other opportunity we can do is swap this out with a shorter sort of service module, kind of like tank. So if we go for this, and this is if we want to preserve the whole tanks up here. So yeah, the total of the first 2 stages, 4,800, that's closer to orbit. So what if I take out you as well? Okay, so 4,400, that will work. It's 10K to launch. It's a 3-stage vehicle, and whether that will actually do better than just going 2-stage, yeah, I mean, let's just take a look again at that 2-stage. So 6,200, this is 4K, so it will get us to orbit at a reasonable takeoff speed as well. So I think I'll stay with this 2-stage as well. It's less money. We don't have to spend it on that LV909. Because we've got that spark engine up here, which is reasonably good. So this can be our sort of first, what should we call it? Explorer. And then we'll have Explorer 1, 2, 3, etc. We should probably put, now that we have towers, we should probably spend on those as well. I know I'm spending a lot of money, but I actually want to have towers from this point rather than you just standing things on the launch pad and assuming that everything is going to be fine. 2 of them will do for this particular case, and then we'll just bring everything down. Okay, so Explorer seems like a decent rocket. We can get rid of that stage, so we can deploy those both at the same time because it's vanilla Kerbal space program. We deploy both at the same time, then that is perfectly fine. Now, do we have any missions that can use it? Let's see. Okay, so here we are. Position satellite in equatorial orbit of Kerbin. We have Apo and Peri of quite good, quite different, but they are inclination of 0 degrees, which is good. Needs a mystery goo unit and an antenna and can generate power. Okay, we have both of those, and we just need a mystery goo unit. So I think we'll accept that. Let's go and adjust, what was that delta V figure again? Because if this doesn't do it, we can always add that extra stage. 6,200, that sounds like it can do it just fine. Okay, so let's launch this thing. The main problem is going to be, do we have a connection back to Kerbin to be able to, to be able to maneuver? Because there's no one on board. And here we are on the launch pad. Yeah, remember throttle up. I'm going to turn the SAS on. We don't have prograde hold or anything like that. And I'll see you in orbit. And here we are about to circularize. So we're coming into our maneuver node for circularization. And let's go. So the 40 second burn, it says. But that's going to be going down pretty quickly. As is our fuel, of course. But that is also fine. I separated out the payload from this separator just to double check. I think it is separate, so we do should need that separator really, which is fine. And in we come. So not very long left, and of course we're almost out of fuel, so it might be worthwhile we're out of fuel, and that's almost exactly where I'd almost want it, because we can get rid of our payload fairings in clamshell deploy mode. We can get rid of stack separator, which leaves us with everything separating, which will then leave us with the rest of our satellite. So activated, we can go back to the node again and just do the rest of that using our existing tiny, tiny spark engine. And we should be in orbit. 88 by 74, we are in orbit. And now, of course, all we have to do is match this. So we can choose when we want to do that. For example, here, we can grab this maneuver, push our orbit out that way. Whoops, that's far too much. Bring it to about here, and then move this around. And then that will naturally match everything with here. We're inclined off a little bit, you know, we're not quite the same, so we may have to correct that. You can correct it halfway around if you want to, and I think that's a little bit more efficient. Or you can just apply a little bit of normal to get that inclination the same. And we should actually really be doing that separately. Yeah, I think I'm going to do it separately because I almost want to do it on the descending node and ascending node to get it to tilt properly. In fact, we could do that first. If I just go via the add a maneuver here, we can change this to match our destination. Why are you... Oh, we have no connection. Okay, anyway, you get the idea. We've done this before, so you shouldn't need to see it again. All I'm going to do is choose at the ascending node in this case, and we go anti-normal, I think, because of the descending node, ascending node, I should say. So let's just go around a little bit. And will I get some kind of connection, please? There we go, connection. And there we go. So I can just go anti-normal, I think. And that should do things. Yeah, there he is, anti-normal. Yeah, so if you're at the ascending node, go anti-normal. Just remember two A's, of course. And then that will then change our inclination. It costs us 6 seconds of fuel, but we have more than enough to deal with that. And then once we're done with that, then we can apply another maneuver opposite here, so we can put in a maneuver in sequence. And so we want to go that away. So that will then take us with the second maneuver out to where we want. And then we can apply a third maneuver out here to go this way. And that is more than close enough. We should get the mission with that. Of course, you shouldn't need to see any of that because you've seen it before, and we are out of time for this episode, unfortunately. But we have got a mission up to the moon done. It was manned. Womaned. Val. Was the female of Kerbals. Not quite sure in that case, particular case, but Val valiantly went out there, spent over a month out there, and now we can get unmanned with maneuvers satellites. And in order to sort that out, let's just extend that satellite so we have a way to communicate. Electric charge is just fine, and we have solar panels on this thing. So it's not an incredible satellite because we need the larger relay antennas for that, but it will get us where we want to go. So I hope you enjoyed this episode. Feel free to give it a thumbs up if you have. Subscribe, share if you haven't already. Click the bell, etc. if you want to get notifications. If not, of course, just ignore it. And as always, thanks for watching.